Welcome to the cast.
Oh shit.
Episode 9.
Oh my god.
Oh my, you just flipped on the on-air light.
The on-air is
fuck
on.
Yeah.
Boys are ready.
Oh, ready
nine.
To roll.
Episode 9, dude.
Coming up on 10 soon.
That's insane.
That's insanity.
Nobody thought we would make it this far.
Nah, dude. Fucking, it feels
so
like it's
crazy.
Been 9 years we've been doing this podcast.
Yep. We've had a steady flow of new listeners.
Yep.
So we're around 48,000.
Yep. Just hovering around under 50K. Shout out, Nate Chapra. What's up, dog?
Oh, is he getting a shout
out? Big shout out, dude. Yeah, he defended me.
How do you defend you?
He said I was pronunciating right
last
week.
Oh, yeah.
It's a
yeah.
big controversy
there are some,
right now.
There are some. Yeah, he was. Apparently, it is Cherubic.
Yep. Well, I'm not going to, you know.
You're not going to rub it in.
I just want to throw a shout out to old Nady Boy. A couple other shout outs rattling around my head. Who else needs a shout out?
I don't know.
It's a little early on.
I always feel bad correcting your
mistakes. Well, A, I need it because I like.
I fucking,
dude, no one corrected me about Adage. I would have gone through life being like Adage, Adage, Adage.
You know that old Adage? And it got laughs and you just kept telling the story.
I was like, hell yeah, I knew this would work. I thought it was a French word.
Adage.
The old adage. I didn't know. This actually has made me realize how many words I've been mispronouncing all these words that I have no fucking clue. Now I know.
Well, you do have a nice, extensive vocabulary.
Yeah,
but
I'm just too shitty to fucking say
them. You just toss in some wild words that you're not ready for. You're not ready for them yet.
I'm not, dude.
But this is how you learn.
I'll never be. I'm as smart as I'll ever be. It's all downhill from here.
Yeah, for sure.
I've pinnacled and now I'm fucking
you've
just
pinnacled?
Like, yeah, I've pinnacled.
I don't think that's correct.
I have a very postmodern approach to language, dude.
You've reached your pinnacle.
I've pinnacled.
That could be right.
Maybe. It is. Maybe. Who knows? Anyway, dude, what the fuck is up?
Nothing, man. I just fucking pinnacled last night into a sock.
Oh, dude, anyway, you pinnacled into a sock?
No, it's funny. It's a good way to say come now.
You came, pinnacled?
I fucking pinnacled all over the place, dude.
I pinnacled.
It was a fucking solid penny.
Oh, I just had some fucking Chipotle, dude.
Nice.
Yeah, big old meal.
I polished off that tray of chicken my mom gave
Did
me.
Did you really?
Yeah. After that
cream chip.
I showed my ass on Saturday.
Yep.
And then I had to drive home. It was so bad that I actually went back to my mom and dad's house. I got so fucked up that I went home and had my mom make my favorite meal. And then she made some for me to bring back to this apartment, and I ate it today.
Yeah, that was such a bad idea. We played drinking Mario Kart where I didn't know how to play this.
All right, well, that's a fucking Philly thing, Mario.
What, Mario?
Mario. It's Mario.
Fucking Mario, dude. Yeah.
Mario.
It's not Mario, dude.
Say Water Mario.
Water Mario.
There you go.
Ew, dude.
Water.
I feel like I'm fucking French.
Water Mario.
Water Mario, dude.
Yeah, Water Mario.
We played drinking Mario Kart. I will not be fucking stopped. And you got to drink your beer.
Super Mario Brothers.
Super Mario Bros.
Yeah.
And you had to drink your whole beer before you finished around the course. I, of course, drank high ABV ciders, 5.5.
Yeah, you had like 7.
Dude,
that's a
I
lot.
Was dead. I drank 7 in the course of maybe 5 hours, and that was an hour and a half maybe.
Yeah, that was nice. I probably put down about 16 or 17 natural lights.
I couldn't
and then
talk.
I put down 16 to 17 natural lights before going to a party that was also a stand-up show. That I was like, you know what? I'm going to fucking bless these people with a sick set. And I just got up there and yelled the worst racial slurs I could. Not the worst one.
Yeah,
I didn't yell that one.
You'd be in the news.
But I just yelled a bunch of racial slurs into the microphone.
Little lighter ones.
And then...
Funner ones.
Yeah, just some of the funner slurs. And then
the ones
I left.
In the Clint Eastwood movie. What's that called?
Gran Torino.
Yeah, Gran Torino.
Yeah, Gran Torino pretty hard. And then went home and woke up the next day.
Went home, sexually assaulted me.
Oh,
I was
God.
Naked in bed and he kept jumping on me.
Oh, yeah. I got home. I was going to leave that out. I got home and Matt was in his bed. He was fucking gone, too.
I was retarded.
So I was bothering him, and then I forgot I took a picture of him. I have a nice cherubic nude of you.
Just my my buttocks, which is cherubic.
Yeah, it was a very cherubic, buxom.
Oh man, dude.
Voluptuous buttocks.
I couldn't talk. Like I rolled into that party, and I looked at like four people, and I was like, "I'm going home." And I just instantly turned. I was there for 1 minute.
It was such a good move.
Yeah, but it was also that was my only good move. I should have not played drinking marriage. I can't drink like that.
Yeah.
After four rounds, I like stood up to get a beer and went to talk to people, and I was like Shane and Brian. And I was just like, my mouth fully.
Mario Kart drinking game is a knockout every time.
It's insane, and you predicted it, and I was like, I'll be fine. And then just was like,
if
God.
You play, I mean, if you do 10 races, every race is like 3 minutes.
It's insane.
So you're chugging a beer every 3 minutes for an hour. Gross. Yeah, it's
why
terrible.
Why the fuck did I think I could do that? Especially, dude, ciders basically like liquor, dude. Those things are strong.
No, they're fucking not. Shut the fuck up.
High ABV ciders, dude?
High ABV? Shut the fuck up.
How many beers did you have?
We finished that case of Natural Light.
So you guys have four Natural Lights? That's equal to like seven ciders.
And I'm certain that I had more than six.
Well, he was cheating. Because
he started cheating.
He was fucking cheating.
He was skipping one or two. So let's say he skipped two. We finished the case. That means I drank 17.
So that's equal to seven ciders, roughly.
You think 17 chugged Natural Lights is equal to fucking a six-pack of your little fucking ciders?
Almost. It's
your
almost
fucking
equal.
Mike's hard.
Damn, dude. That put so much hair on my chest, drinking those ciders like that.
Oh, my God. That was like... And it's funny, because after New Year's, I was like, all right, maybe fucking...
Dude.
Once we had a little snow day here.
That's
anytime
true.
It snows.
Oh, yeah.
And I didn't have a show that night.
Yeah, why not?
It's like the first Saturday I haven't had a show in a while. So I was like, all right, I'm going to have a nice fucking day drink. I never get to day drink.
Dude, I woke up that morning. I totally forgot. I was supposed to celebrate. My birthday is the 27th. My mom texted me earlier that week to celebrate it. She's like, we're going to celebrate you and your dad's birthday in one shot, get it done, whatever. Like, all right, so like I just woke up to text like, hey, you coming home? We have your birthday thing set up. And I was like, it was like the morning.
Oh,
like
my
breakfast.
God.
Come home, we have your birthday thing set up. So everyone's waiting for me to eat, and I had to like come in, like pretend to not be hungover. Oh. Like, hey, guys, what's going on?
I think I woke up in the boots again.
Did you?
Fully clothed.
In full regalia.
Full fucking outfit. Boots
like
tied tight.
Like a fucking G.I. Joe character.
Dude, I fucking wake up in that outfit so many times. And I'm just, every time I do, I'm like, God, fucking damn it.
I always kind of sober up before I go to bed. But I also was chain smoking joints while I was drinking. So that
That
keeps a voice of reason in my head. That was like the voice of when I walked in that party. I was like, this is wrong, leave. And I was like, yes.
Nice.
Just got out of there.
If I would have smoked anything, I would have been dead.
Dead.
I mean, I was already pretty bad.
I don't. It's some. Everyone says I get the spins. For me, it keeps me awake. It keeps me fighting, dude. I like ordered myself an Uber, like got myself home, and was just like, bedtime for you, bud.
That's nice. Good for you. I thought it was time for me to dance in the middle of that party all night.
Yeah.
and then take the stage. Then get on the fucking mic. In front of a room full of people that don't like me.
Yeah, and then just add more logs to that fire.
Yep, yep. Somebody was looking. I remember it. Somebody was looking at me. I was like, "Don't you fucking look at me like that, you piece of shit." People were like, "Whoa, whoa, dude!" I was like, "Fuck you."
Oh my God, I couldn't. I was incoherent. I would have been up there and just been like,
that's actually what I did.
I would have been up there doing like magic tricks and like taking dollars off of people.
good for you. I was really jealous when I found out you went home.
Well, I was also kind of jealous that you could somehow drink more than seven drinks and not fucking want to, like, pass out in your bed. I was watching you guys drink just like, these guys are insane. I don't know how they do this.
Yeah, I was putting on a show.
I had such a bellyache, dude.
That was easy 17. I'm giving six credit on that.
Yeah.
Because he stopped, and then I do remember... Because Rainbow Road in Super Mario Kart is that's a two-drink race because that's a long one. So you got to finish two beers.
So I had one. I drank one drink.
You drank one. I put two down. And then I think afterwards I was like, look how fast I can chug a beer. And just had another one.
You did.
Yeah.
You definitely did. Fuck.
That was one that, like, I think I am gonna stop. I know I'm not
I'm still sad.
I'm not gonna drink this weekend.
Yeah.
So that's a good 2 week break.
I'm sad. I need to go back to the old regiment, dude, of maybe drinking every now and again. I've been drinking too much.
Yeah, you have been, man.
And I drink like the fucking gayest drinks. I like have like a cider problem.
You do. You fucking crush ciders.
I don't though. I have like four and I'm like, ooh.
Well, that's a fucking ton of sugar and you never have
that's
sugar.
That's true too. I think it's the sugar more than anything.
For sure.
I think I have diabetes now and sleep
that's
apnea.
That's not how you're not gonna get diabetes.
And sleep apnea. I have both right now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Nice.
That's why I'm fucking out of sorts.
Dude. Nice.
Oh, I didn't even tell you, dude, I was at Chipotle. I didn't even get into this. So I'm ordering my food. And I'm checking out. I'm like, you know, getting ready to get the fuck out of there. And you can do like internet orders.
Yeah.
And this fucking student, I guess from Drexel, just like, 100% Asian dude, rolls cuts me off.
Can you do a story without crushing
Asian people?
No,
it's not. I'm not crushing them, dude. It was just so funny how this guy came up because a lot of people who come from another country and go to Drexel are from like super fantastically wealthy backgrounds.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So this guy comes up, just decked out in polo, cuts me off while I'm talking to the cashier, checking out. He goes, puts his phone in her face and goes, I placed an internet order. And the girl's just like, all right, yeah. And I just turned and was just like, what the fuck? And she like read my face and got all uncomfortable. And I was just like, you fucking believe this guy? She was just like, not having it. I was so fucking mad. And he just like looked at me and was like, and held his phone back out. And I was like, motherfucker, dude.
You don't like that.
I don't like anyone doing that, dude. It has nothing to do with him being Asian. It was just funny that he came in just fully like peasants and fucking handed his in her inches from her face, and she was just kind of backing away, like, "What the fuck are you doing?"
I have an order for Chipotle.
Dude, I was laughing so fucking hard.
I use the Google. I use the internet Google to order Chipotle.
It was the funniest fucking thing. He came in, he had like full on like polo snow boots and like a tight fucking polo sweatshirt, and came in like a prince and was just like, I placed the order. And everyone was like, all right, man, get the fuck out of here.
Oh, man.
The time is nigh, dude. That's not a fucking racist thing. That guy was being a dickhead, and he didn't even know it because he probably grew up with like 90 servants and was just like, I'll get my food now.
Oh, man.
It was so funny to see that lady, how uncomfortable she
every
was.
Every time I'm in there, I'm just trying to sweet talk the people into giving me extra food. Like the whole time, like, hey, what's going on, man? How are you?
I just live comment every scoop. I'm like, nice. Okay. I start with the rice. I'm like, ooh, great, nice.
Once they get the chicken, I'm like, don't be afraid to toss a little extra.
I get the carnitas. For some reason, they dole out carnitas like crazy because no one gets them.
That's a big secret you're giving out to the listeners.
Everyone's scared of E. coli. Don't be fucking scared.
Don't be afraid of
E. coli.
E. coli
can get you. You're a pussy.
True.
That shouldn't be able to get you.
No.
Your body should fight that off. You're getting E. coli. Stay the fuck out of Chipotle. How about that?
Fuck yeah, baby.
Yeah, I'm back, dude. I was fucking sullen for 2 days. I don't know. I think
you were.
Mentally, I get hungover for
sullen,
like...
Sullen, huh?
Oh, yeah, baby.
I think you got that one right.
Of course I did. That's an easy one. As I spill water on my chin.
Water. Spill water all over the place.
That's how I talk, dude.
That's the only fucking Philly accent you have.
Yeah, water.
Is
I say
water.
Kindergarten.
Kindergarten?
No, I don't. I wish I did.
Say, Jesus Christ.
No, my dad says kindergarten Monday, Tuesday.
Yeah, I was going to say Monday, Tuesday.
Monday, Tuesday. I don't say that. Yeah, I just say, if I say water, I feel fucking weird.
On Monday, the kids at kindergarten were playing Super Mario. I had to come in there and give them a bunch
Monday,
of water.
Give them a little water.
Yeah, it is a really ugly accent.
Water, dude. Water.
Water.
I always picture like surfers from California being like, get in the water.
No, it's just water.
Ugh.
Can I get a glass of water? Ugh. Dude, fucking water.
Water, dude. That's how you call it.
Water.
How do you say, like, crowns? You say crayon?
Oh, I always say crayons. C-R-A-N-S.
Crayons?
Yeah, that's on me. That's not like an accent thing. That's just me. I can't say crayon.
You call them crowns, dude.
Crowns? Well, that's way worse. I just say crayon.
Crayon?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's kind of weird, too.
My accent, I have, it's like I'll say hem.
You have that, you start getting that like
Yeah, it's almost like a weird Midwestern.
Yeah, and they ask like questions. Like,
yeah,
are you going there?
Yeah, that's how
What's going on, dude?
Are you going outside?
Yeah.
Like if you, it, like I'll see you walking outside and be like, "You going outside?"
Yeah, it is. That's yeah, that yeah. like
always
Western that, PA thing.
It's like a fucking Irish accent. It's like I gotta go home.
Yeah, dude, it is.
I'm going home.
It's I don't know. Yeah, kind of.
You going outside?
It always reminds me of a gnome. People are like, "Well, you going outside, dude?" I'm like, "What the fuck are you talking about?" Kind of Canadian, really.
Yeah, it's true.
It's north.
Yeah, yeah.
You
yeah.
are northern PA. It's close to Canada.
I am fucking Nordic. Viking-esque.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, so I was up in the Big Apple last night.
Oh, baby.
Man, I hate that fucking city. Especially, I was at Caroline, so it was just Times Square.
Oh, that's where that is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's in Times Square. It's on Broadway. And it's like, it is a fucking nightmare.
Yeah, driving up there sucks. It also
driving
sucks.
Up there, it wasn't bad. It really isn't bad. Driving up there, it's like an hour and 45 minutes.
No, I'm saying within, driving through Times Square, which is a pain in
oh,
the ass.
Oh, driving through Times Square sucks dick.
Yeah, I did it through rush hour one time. I was like, this is a nightmare.
yeah.
It sucks.
Although I did go through the Lincoln Tunnel at like 5.
How was that?
That sucked.
Pretty bad?
Yeah, that sucked.
You predicted that. You were like, I'm going to go there right at rush hour.
It's like 8 lanes go down to 1 lane.
Ugh.
Yeah. And it's all just shitty fucking people that will never let you in.
Oh, no, dude.
It's unbelievable.
It's unthinkable to be like, go ahead, man.
Yeah.
Unfucking thinkable.
Also, I'm way too fucking big for that city. Like, there's just clusters of people walking together at all times. I just bump into everyone.
Yeah, I think you are, honestly. I mean.
Yeah, I'm too big for that city.
It's fucking annoying.
Every fucking, like, if I'm on a subway or something, people, like.
New York is for short people. It's for like 5'5" and under.
Tiny
it's,
little
yeah,
guys wearing scarves, fucking
like
cool
gloves.
Glasses.
Yeah, I mean like
leather gloves.
This is the best place ever. It is for fucking dorks. New York City
if
is for
New
dorks.
New York City didn't have stand up. There's no way
I'd
go up there.
I would never. I hate how much everyone loves it too. This is just the energy I feel. It's like, dude.
Yeah, it's
fuck
a
off.
Fucking horrific energy.
Fuck off. This place sucks.
But that is what I used to be like when I was younger. I used to think this is back when I thought shit was cool.
Yeah,
I used to like go up to New York and be like, "Oh my god, man. This is the city. This is where it's happening."
Yeah.
But that was back when I like liked art.
That's so funny.
And books.
I went on a field trip up there when I was a young man and I was like, "Fuck this place." I actually hated it, started to kind of like it, and then I went back up there for stand-up, and I was like, yeah, I hate this place again. Just watching people.
Anytime I do stand-up, it's cool, but dealing with the thousands of comics there fucking sucks.
That's kind
of,
it does suck.
Yeah, it sucks. Because, like, if you don't do stand-up there, they don't fucking, obviously, they have no idea who you are, so it's like.
Yeah, that and the whole thing of, like, it's just, like, jaded me. Like, I'm, like, jaded now. It's like, dude,
I'm just such a jaded
comic. Shut up. You've been on, like, 2 podcasts. You're not fucking jaded.
Yeah.
I'm just jaded now.
Yeah.
All these showcases and podcasts I've done. It's like, dude.
I'm jaded to art.
Yeah.
And all that shit. Like.
Like, Andrew Dice Clay is jaded. Eddie Murphy is jaded. If you, like, have flown down, like, Sunset Boulevard in a Ferrari with hookers, it's like, all right, dude, you're jaded.
Yeah, but
I've been on Tinder a lot, and it's like, you're not fucking jaded.
Yeah.
You're slowly dying. You're just getting older, and you're 35, and your body's tired.
When I went to Madrid, I went and I lived in Spain because of, I liked Ernest Hemingway.
That's so funny.
And I was like, I'm going to go live in Spain, man. Then I got to Spain, and I was like, fuck. This fucking sucks.
This is why this guy shot himself
in
the
head. Yeah, this fucking sucks. Madrid's like New York in that.
Really?
It's just a ton of super stylish people walking around like.
Fuck. Yeah, yeah.
And then I'm walking around in a fucking Notre Dame hoodie and sweatpants. People are looking at me like, who the fuck is this giant idiot? I was so much bigger than everyone there.
Oh, I bet.
I was literally like 3 of every... You could pick 3 people in Madrid, and I was their size.
Jesus
combined.
Christ. That's fucked.
Yeah,
they're
really
all like
funny.
Slender, like little
and
sketcher
even, like,
wearing.
Even like the townspeople, like, because I lived in kind of a northern suburb that was like all Spanish people.
Yeah.
Even them, they were like 5'5", little pot-bellied dudes.
Really?
Yeah.
It's weird.
Yeah,
I still want to live in Brazil. That was my plan.
Oh, yeah?
I like, graduated school. I was like, I'm definitely moving to Brazil. And then, like, started working for my brother. And I was like, well, I'll just do this. This is good, too.
Yeah, I'll just stay here.
I went there for 10 days, and I was like, this place rules.
Yeah. I mean, Spain's awesome, and I will go back. Spain's the fucking shit. But it's just funny to like, even my old Spotify playlists and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'll listen to music that I used to listen to and just be like, what the f-? Like I'll listen to Vampire Weekend.
Yeah.
Be like, who the fuck did I think I was? Like I was like, F. Scott Fitzgerald's like a really amazing author.
Yeah.
Like,
that's so funny.
I know for a fact that I have said to people that John Steinbeck is the greatest American author of all time.
Really?
Like, I've literally said that in a conversation. How fucking... What a stupid...
Yeah, well...
Cunty thing to fucking say to anybody. I was like 23.
Oh, that's the thing,
like,
yeah.
I mean, I'm fucking 29 now. It'd be weird if I said it now.
Yeah, but when you're, like, that's the golden age of when you're, like...
Yeah,
I have everything figured out. This is amazing.
Yeah.
And slowly that just like you're from like 20 to 23, you're purely operating on delusions. Like you're purely operating on fantasy world,
yeah,
and then
that
slowly just gets fucking shit away, and you're just like, ah, fuck, god damn it.
Yeah.
Now I know why my dad used to sit in a chair and just stare at the wall for like 4 hours a day.
Yeah, he used to just watch sports. He goes home and turns on sports and just sits there.
Yeah,
and he's like, all right.
Dude, my dad would just sit in a chair and just sit there and just be like, and just stare at a wall.
Oh,
and be like,
God.
Listen, he would like listen to like Al Stewart and just like stare. I'm like, I totally get that. After I got married, I was like, oh, I know what he was doing. Or when he would like sit in his truck, he would like get home from work and sit in his truck for like a half an hour. Like, what the fuck's
nice,
he doing?
That's a nice moment.
He'd sit down and like call people. Just be like, what the fuck are you going?
That's a nice moment.
I know.
To just fucking sit there by yourself.
I just watch him sit in his truck and I'm like, what the fuck's he doing out there?
It's funny, after the show... So we did that show at Caroline's, and then we were going to go to the Cellar afterwards, which was awesome, but there was like an hour and a half break.
Uh-huh.
And the other, like, Billy and them wanted to go to a bar afterwards, and I was like, I kind of just want to sit in my fucking car.
Yeah.
For like an hour.
Just sitting there.
Listen to music, throwing a dip, just fucking relax. Yeah.
Yeah, that is always nice.
But, yeah, now that I'm super fucking jaded, I'm so jaded. I hate art.
Oh, hell yeah, dude.
I used to go to museums by myself.
What?
Like, in Madrid, I would just go and, like, look
what
at...
What kind of museums? Like,
the best museums in the world.
Like, old spoons and shit? Like,
no, not, like, fucking antiques, but, like, fucking, like, art, like Picasso. And
yeah. I'm telling you, man, you can't keep me in a museum for more than 10 minutes. I can go to the art museum. I can go and look at paintings, and that's nice.
Yeah.
I've been to, like, the Franklin, like, the Smithsonian, whatever the fuck that's
called.
Yeah. It's like, this is the King Tut exhibit, and it's like, oh, here's a fucking necklace some guy wore. I'm like, I don't fucking care.
When Caitlin and I first started dating, we went to D.C. for a weekend.
Yep.
And I had mono,
mm-hmm.
and I didn't know it.
Where'd you get the mono from?
I'm not sure.
Probably sports.
No.
Sharon
this
bottles.
Was long after sports. This
what?
Was, we went down, maybe. I was playing a lot of basketball back then. But I worked at a car dealership.
Okay.
So I was shaking hands.
Yeah, but you got a kissing disease. You got to share water bottles or make out. Only two options.
I don't think that's right.
The kissing disease.
I know that's what it's called.
I
don't think
it
that's right.
Kissing disease.
Yeah.
It's only from making out, dude.
But no, I had that, so like... It was fucking August, and she was like, I just want to walk around the city.
Yeah.
Like, we just started dating, so, like, I'm not going to be like, fuck no.
I love walking around the city.
Yeah, so I was like, oh, that'd be great.
Yeah.
So, like, we're walking, like, miles through this August fucking D.C. heat, and I had fucking mono. I was like, I'm just so tired. Like,
oh, my God.
But it was a date, so I didn't want to be like...
Yeah.
You know how fat that makes you look to be like, we walked 3 blocks, I'm like, oh my God, I gotta lay down.
Yeah, let's not, yeah.
Like, I gotta go back to the hotel and
you were
sleep.
Just chucking it out.
So we chucked it out and then went to the fucking Smithsonian.
Really?
So like, I had to, with mono, had to like, be like, oh, that's really cool. At the Air and Space Museum, I'm looking at planes hanging from the rafters.
Yep,
like,
I've been to
oh,
those things.
Cool.
I was in and fucking out. I looked in there and I was like, well, this one sucks. And I went to the other one. I'm like, yeah, this sucks too. And then like we went to one, the Native American one.
You like that one. You like the Savages.
That was tight. I liked the art. The Native American art was tight. That was the only thing I looked at. I'm
yeah.
like, this is cool.
The art museums in Madrid are like, dude, I used to go to the fucking MoMA in New York.
Yeah.
The Museum of Modern Art and like think it was cool. Modern art is
sucks.
Fucking garbage.
We went there like a field trip and there was one exhibit which was a cubicle. Someone just built a cubicle.
Yeah, it's fucking
like,
trash.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Like, I think there was an article, somebody left a pair of glasses on the ground, and people started, like, taking pictures of it, and were like, oh my God.
Jesus Christ.
Such a powerful reflection of society.
Well, the art world's a sick and twisted world of, like, just nothing but, like, trust fund millionaires.
Yeah,
and
of course.
You go up there, and it's, like, it's insane.
Yeah,
and there's some people obviously are watercolorists and sculptors.
A bunch of watercolorists,
insanely talented.
Like this one Italian artist, Mario. Mario's a big watercolor artist.
Who was that one Ninja Turtle who was really good at art? Fucking Michelangelo.
They all were.
I know.
Michelangelo. Is it
sir?
Michelangelo.
Yeah, dude.
Not Michelangelo.
Michelangelo.
Michelangelo, dude.
Michelangelo.
You fucking bitch.
Ooh. Shane's getting fired up.
Yeah, all this art talk is bringing back a part of me that I hate.
Oh, my God. I'm trying to think what I used to do that was, like, so fucking dumb.
And what's really funny is that's, like, what I used to trick Caitlin into liking me.
Oh, yeah, everyone does,
like,
dude.
I was, like, that's who I was at the time.
Yeah.
That's really who I was.
To an extent, everyone throws out, you know when Sub-Zero throws out the ice version of himself
yeah.
to trap someone in?
Here's a cool guy I came up with. I'm big into, like, Hunter S. Thompson, so, like, I'm pretty much just, like, a freewielding.
Yeah.
Big, like, I love Bukowski. I'm, like, a big drinker, fucking. You know what Bukowski says? He says, never get out of bed before noon.
Yeah, dude.
That's funny. I still think of that every day I wake up after noon.
Yeah, like, hell
I'm
yeah.
like, all right, I get it.
Dude, I had a weird period when I was younger so I moved into a house in West Philly that me and my brother split. We got it for like $15,000. The guy let us pay him zero interest over time. And I like moved into this house and I was like obsessed with the idea of living in an undisturbed ecosystem. So I was like, I didn't kill any bugs. I let all my spiders go. I had ladybugs nesting.
God.
I had ladybugs nesting in there. I had stray cats living with me. It was
Get
fucking
the
nuts.
Fuck out of here.
Swear to God.
You had stray cats?
Yes. Garfield, dude. Garfield in the house. This big orange cat.
He was probably so mean, dude.
Dude, he was a sweetheart.
Really?
So he would like go from house to house, but he would get fucked. I would let him out during the day. So he would come in. First, I was like, yo, dude, you can be in here, but only downstairs is winter. I'm like, only downstairs. And he, of course, would come up to the door. And I'm
yeah,
like,
you
all
would
right.
talk to him.
Yeah,
listen to you.
Yeah, but you'd be in my room. But I was like, no, can't get on my bed. And then, of course, on my bed. I'm like, yeah. So I'm like,
you had
this thing.
Flea-ridden fucking stray cat.
I ended up with fleas in my house.
Yeah, of course.
This thing had fucking, like, it would come in with, like, open sores from, like, outdoor cat battles and just be, like, oozing in my bed. And I was like, God damn it. My brother would come into my house. He's like, dude, I know you don't fucking, like, smoke crack, but it really looks like you do in here. He's like, you got to turn it around. And I was like, dude, germs aren't real. Like, wasn't using soap. What?
Yeah, dude, you always...
I was convinced germs weren't real.
You always
like,
have theories that are just so fucking dumb.
Dude,
no
I was
offense,
convinced...
No,
no
offense.
I don't care. Like my
Not so far. I was a little harsh there.
No, it's true. The fact that I was like against hundreds of years of documented science, and I was like, yeah, but I'm pretty sure germs aren't real, just because like, I was stoned one day, and I'm like, yeah, right. And then my theory about birth control... How all women on birth control
great.
All get their periods at the exact same time.
Yeah,
that's why they can't get along.
So Matt told me this one. And he was like, yeah, all women are on their period at the exact same time.
Yeah, I thought they all started the beginning of the month.
Every single woman that was on birth control, which is like every single chick that's 20,
mm-hmm.
in their 20s and 30s, has their period the same time of the month. So like I was like, I don't think that's true. But like I was like, all right, I'm going to try it. And I, like, said something like that to Caitlin.
Yeah.
And, like, she immediately just dismissed. Like, I softballed it up to her. I was like, yeah, like, you know, how they're all on this. You guys are all on the same cycle now.
Yeah.
And she's like, what? And we just kept driving. Like, yeah, I knew that was bullshit.
That was based off of, yeah, because Brittany had her period while Caitlin did. They both were on birth control, I thought.
Disgusting, yes.
So I, in my head, was like, bam, they all get it at the exact same time. They all start at the first of the month, and then the 30th.
Yeah,
but yes, they definitely don't do that.
Yep.
Well, it was a good theory.
It's not a bad theory. I appreciated it. I mean, I believed it enough to test your theory.
That was funny.
Made me look like a fucking idiot.
Yeah, that was bad.
Did you hear that? Idiot. Let's say fucking retard again.
Idiot.
Made me look like a retard idiot.
Hey.
But... Yeah, there was a time in my life that I thought museums were the shit.
That's so
and
funny.
Fucking art was cool.
God,
and,
that's
and
so funny.
Discussing literature.
That's the best. That's how you get ass, dude. That's all you're going off
and
of.
And in hindsight, that's just...
I used to wear button-down shirts and gel my hair, dude. Like, we're all trying to get ass somehow.
True.
I used to wear button-down shirts with, like, stripes and be like, I'm definitely getting ass tonight.
Yeah.
Put some fucking mousse in my hair. Go out and be like, chicks love when you spike your front of your hair.
Dude, watching you go out and just your theories on chicks must have been the funniest things in the world.
They were ridiculous. Well, that was back when you would have to, like, fucking, like... grab a chicken like rodeo rider and be like, do you like me?
Yeah.
Every now and again, one would just be like drunk enough to turn around and make out with you. It was insane.
Oh, God.
It was pure sexual assault. Like, that's my 20s were like massive. That's what people did.
Yeah.
You go to Old City, you had a button down, gelled hair, and you fucking grab chicks from behind and fucking like hump them while they dance. That's how you did it, dude. It's how you got ass.
How do you feel about what you said?
That's what everybody did. Girls would fucking do it. They would turn around and be like, sometimes they dance, or their friend would be like, get off and push. And you'd be like, fuck you, whore, and like walk away. that's all you did. And you do one shot of SoCo and lime and be like, what a bitch.
Oh, man.
It was insanity.
I'm going to switch the subject here to, because you said sexual assault, and it just reminded me of college football.
Yeah.
And, Not that it was sexual assault, but Joe Mixon, that running back from Oklahoma, that punched that lady in the face.
When did he do that?
You didn't see that?
No.
He did it like year or two ago.
Okay.
Maybe three, but the footage just came out, and it was fucking hilarious. In their bowl game, Oklahoma's bowl game, he played, and Brett Musburger, so I don't even think he served a suspension.
Who's Brett Musburger?
He's an announcer, a college football announcer.
So he got caught doing
this? No. The player did. But then Brett Musburger during the game, or Brett, whatever. Okay. During the game, he's like, I, for one, am a fan of second chances. I think I'm rooting hard for this guy. He didn't even
like, know what he did?
No, he knew exactly what he did.
But he was like, yeah.
He was like, I'll tell you what. This kid, he's just a young kid. He made a stupid mistake. I'm rooting for him. And it just went back to the game. He's like, and it's second 9.
What the fuck?
It was like a 10-second fucking like.
Oh, my God.
There he goes. He's working hard. He's trying to get his name back out there.
Oh, my God.
I'll tell you what. He's a good kid. Sorry about that time he knocked out a girl in a pizza shop.
Yeah, that is. Seriously, like, what would it take, dude, for someone just to, like, totally swear off? Not even the NFL would be like, all right, dude, you can't play football anymore. It would have to be like joining ISIS. That's the only thing you could do.
I don't know. Fucking Ray Rice. He got ousted.
He's done now?
Yeah.
No one will sign him back?
No one signed him.
Was he a Raven player?
Yeah, he was in the NFL, and he was really good. Then he knocked that chick out.
And that was that?
Caveman dragged her out of the elevator.
So he was done. They fired him.
I think he can still play, but nobody's picking him up.
Yeah, no one's picking him up. That's a bad look.
I mean, a lot of players...
Oh, they'll wait like 2 years. Slide him back.
Yeah, his shelf life is done, though. He's done.
Oh, yeah.
Talent-wise.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think, because a ton of players have assaulted their girlfriends. It's just when the tape comes out.
Yeah.
When you see how bad it is.
Dude, he fucking
devastated her. This was just as bad.
Was it really?
Nah, maybe not just as bad, because the girl stayed on her feet. She had a good chin, dude.
She was like Rousey, dude.
She didn't go down. She was getting banged around. She fucking stayed
on
her feet. She
was bobbing and weaving.
One of her gay friends broke it up. This gay dude was like, oh my God. And then the guy just walks out, and everyone's like, all right. It was funny.
That's fucking
crazy. I mean, it wasn't funny. It's weird. Anytime watching a chick get hit is pretty hard to fucking...
Yeah, it's fucking horrendous.
Like, I fucking hated Snooki, but when that dude on Jersey Shore turned around and fucking popped her,
ugh. He popped her?
Yeah, she was, like, mouthing off to some guy at a bar, and he, like, turns his head and looks at her.
She's probably got, like, Muhammad Ali brain, dude. She's probably been popped, like, 100 fucking times.
Down Jersey Shore getting fucking knocked around by those guys.
Fucking nailed by Guidos.
Yeah. Jesus Christ.
Stop disrespecting my family. What did you say about me, familia?
Dude, you're Polish. you're a Polak from fucking Rhode Island.
We should go down
to
Jersey Shore this summer and pretend to be Italian. That'd be sick.
Oh, my God. I'd get fucking run, dude.
you'd be a hard sell, dude.
My fucking pale ass skin.
Yeah, I'd be a hard sell, too.
Yeah, we'd just have to get some, like, Ireland tattoos.
That'd be tight.
Yeah, we're here, too, dude. Oh, the hardest fighters in the world. Oh, that was what I wanted to say, because we were talking about... What the fuck were we talking about? New Yorkers suck.
Yeah.
English and Irish people fucking suck.
Yeah.
When I was over there, And I have a nice theory on this. It's because they don't have black people to keep them in check.
Yeah?
All the white dudes over there, there's nobody cooler than them.
Yeah, exactly.
They have no black dudes to be like, yo, fucking...
Yeah.
You look goofy as fuck in that outfit.
Yeah.
They just walk around like, oh, hey, let me tell you about this. Hey, fucking...
they really don't.
Yeah, that's why all the best... This is a good theory I've been working on. This is why all the best basketball players in the NBA are foreign. All the white kids in America quit in, like, eighth grade.
Yeah, they're like, well...
When a kid from the city school dunks in eighth grade, they're just like, all right, I better start studying.
That is a good theory.
Yeah, that's why Dirk Nowitzki, Steve Nash is up in Canada,
yep,
balling out on white kids.
Hell yeah. And, like, Drake's.
Yeah.
Just, like, crossing Drake
yeah,
over.
Yeah, a bunch of fucking pussies. Yeah, Dirk was in Germany. It's like, of course.
Oh, dude, yeah.
Over there, he was the fucking man.
Yeah.
And then
it's a good theory.
Yeah.
I was thinking the other day about how, because I know black Americans and African immigrants don't get along typically.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A lot of times. Yeah. I was thinking how that's basically, that's like their English people. Like African immigrants are like black people's English people. You know, I'm like an English person speaks, you're like, fucking shut up, you dork. It's got to be
a similar thing.
Where it's like, all right, dude.
Yeah,
fuck
we get
off.
It.
Yeah. You're from like the first place. Whatever. I get it. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a deep-seated beef, dude.
That was a funny thing, too, that I changed. Like, when I was younger, I was like, fuck yeah, like, Dropkick Murphys and fucking...
Oh, man.
Boondock Saints is the shit. And then I met, like, five Irish guys, and I was like, all right, I'm definitely American. fuck being Irish. These people suck.
Yeah, my last name's McCusker. My dad still, to this day, claims he's not Irish. He's like, they're fucking losers, dude. He's like, I'm all English. He's like, fuck Ireland. He hates it. A bunch of lazy pieces of shit. He hates Ireland.
Nah, my family still, like, loves being Irish.
My mom's side loves it. My dad's just like, I'm not Irish. He's like, I'm Welsh.
It is always funny when people blame their heritage.
Yeah.
Like, my family's a bunch of alcoholics, so they're like, you know, we're just a bunch of Irish people.
Yeah.
It's like, I mean, I don't remember the Irish being known for chugging Natural Light during the fucking, during the fucking Raiders game.
That is a sick thing to do.
Yeah, that is. Every single fucking Irish person I met over there, and they're everywhere.
Yeah.
They just are fucking the most, they know it all. They
yeah.
know everything.
That's a heavy, that like, is a heavy Irish curse.
Like, that and, because anytime you're over there, all they want to talk about is how many guns Americans have. They're just,
yeah.
They're all, like, fascinated that we have guns.
Yeah.
They have no idea. And I'm like, I don't have a fucking gun.
Yeah.
But they're like, oh, let me tell you what's wrong with your country.
Yeah.
You got too many guns, don't you? I'd be like, all right, man. How about your fucking island that got defeated by potatoes?
Yeah, dude.
Like, fuck off.
How about your shitty third world country? Yeah, Northern Ireland's like a third world country. It was, like, in the 80s. It was just
I think they turned around. I think they
running
had
water
a pretty
and shit.
Massive
yeah.
economic boom.
Now, yeah, the Tiger. I forget, there was some sort of thing. There was, like, a big boom there.
What'd you say about Tiger?
Something, there was like some thing over there called like the Legion of the Tiger or some shit.
The Legion of the Tiger?
I don't know. My friend was telling me about it. He's from Ireland.
I can't wait to Google what that real
dude,
answer is.
I don't know what he was talking about. It's like some Labor Party or some shit.
You remind me, you do remind me of my dad in that you will just guess.
Oh, 100%.
Like if you're not sure on something, you're not going to like keep it to yourself. You're going to let that first.
I'm going
to
rip it out, dude.
Guess out. I was saying last night, I was like, my dad's like a broken Alexa. Like, you can ask him anything, and he's like, he'd be like, what's it like outside today? He'd be like, the Orioles are playing, the Orioles play at 8 p.m. against the Red Sox. Like, all right. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, like, all right, dude.
Or he just guesses names. Like, you're like, what?
You're fucking with your dad's Alexa is the funniest thing.
Oh, yeah. If you're like, Dad, we'll be watching a movie, and he'll, like, Home Alone's on. I'll be like, What's this, Home by Yourself? We were watching Home by Yourself.
My dad just puts that in front of it. Anything he, like, thinks he might get judged for liking.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's like, when my sister's listening to NSYNC, he's like, yeah, Kathleen's playing that, NSYNC?
What's it called?
And it's like, dude, he has to, like, verbally distance himself from it.
It's a good move.
It's a tight move. That what's that called? That Brokeback Mountain movie there? What's that called? That thing? This is like, all right, dude. I get it. You're not fucking gay. You can say it.
Oh man, hot cast.
It's a hot cast. Long cast, dude.
Is it long?
Probably like 40 minutes.
Oh wow, we should probably stop then.
Yeah, let's fucking stop. These people had enough.
This is enough. This is all you get for the week.
Yeah. We back Tuesday next time. We keep delaying because we're busy as fuck.
Because we're artists.
Exactly.
And we were hungover.
Still am. Still hurt.
Yeah.
Still sad.
You got any shout-outs before we close this thing?
Who was about to shout-out? Chris Brown. Big fucking shout-out to Chris Brown.
Oh, yeah. You've been following that pretty hard. Chris Brown. Oh, I thought you were talking about Chris Brown, Soulja Boy.
Oh, well, shout-out to C. Breezy, too.
Who are you cheering for in that?
Ah, man.
I know you're a big Soulja Boy.
I want to see Soulja take him out, dude. But I saw Breezy hitting the bag, and Breezy has it. He was hitting the bag.
That'd be sick if Soulja Boy...
I want to see Soulja Boy win, though.
In a fucking one-punch
knockout.
Just
a one-punch wild world star, like, overhanging hook or some weird shit.
Oh, dude. I know we're going long.
Go ahead.
World star. And you're right. Like, that's... When they showed Soulja Boy shadowboxing, that was just pure world star fucking...
It is, dude.
Does anybody on earth have a weaker chin than everybody in a fucking world star video?
Dude,
they slapbox with their heads backwards until someone gets fucking knocked out, and it's always ridiculous.
It's just eyes closed, cartoon windmill punches, dude. Until someone catches one, they're like,
connects, and the other guy's out, totally out. They have the weakest fucking chins on earth.
Like Rock'em Sock'em Robots, dude. It's just like,
don't get me wrong. There's some vicious, obviously horrific punches.
Yeah,
but I've seen some of the weakest knockouts.
Yeah.
Like, these guys must, like, walk around the house and, like, bump into things and get knocked out. Like, this is fucking crazy. Because they hit their head on a shelf and just lay down.
And then someone comes out of nowhere like, oh!
Yeah, and their whole family runs in, fucking screams and takes their shoes. Yeah, that was good racism, man, this thing.
That's not racism, that's a world star.
All right. I think that's good.
That's great.
All right.
Always a strong closer. Take us the fuck out of here.
Peace out, dude. Podcast. It's been real.